Darwin was born on the 12th of February, 1809, Darwin Day. In honor of Darwin Day, we issued an appeal for questions on evolution that I might answer, and I'm going to now answer them. I've always believed homosexuality was nature's population control so that we don't overpopulate thoughts. That's a very tempting error, not with respect to homosexuality, but with respect to the idea that nature does population control. That's not the way nature works. It's so tempting to think, oh, well, things will be best for the species, so nature will do whatever it takes to keep the species going, and that's just not the way evolution works. Natural selection works at the level of the individual gene. So in order for natural selection to favor population control, natural selection would have to favor a gene or genes in an individual that limited that individual's reproduction. Homosexuality would do that, but of course it wouldn't actually be naturally selected, because the individual that doesn't have the children doesn't pass on the genes for not having children. In order for natural selection to favor population control, it would have to be the case that an individual that has too many children ends up rearing fewer. And this was worked out by the great ornithologist David Lack, who studied clutch size in various species of birds. A bird that lays more than the optimum number of eggs ends up rearing fewer because there's not enough food for them. A bird that begins by laying too few eggs also ends up rearing fewer for more obvious reasons. There's an optimum number of eggs which a bird species will lay. That's the extent of population control adaptation. So I'm afraid it couldn't be true that homosexuality is an adaptation to keep the population size down.